Changing the clutch drum bearings is very simple. Using a heat gun, we can replace these ball bearings in 5 minutes or so. Now we will show you how to do it. And release the tension directly to the kit. Start by introducing a little bit of the spring, a rubber band, like this. Ratchet, long extension, short extension, 10 mm suspension. Hi there, my name is Stefan. Welcome back to the Paramotor Engine Maintenance Series. In today's episode, we will show you how to change the clutch drum bearings. It's very simple and very fast. First, you need to remove the clutch drum. Please be sure that you watched the video where we showed you how to change the clutch, because there you can see how easy and fast you can remove this part from the engine. I will attach a link with the video in the description down below. Now that we have the clutch drum removed, using special pliers, we need to remove the C-clip. And now it's time to remove the bearings. What I like to do is just to heat up the whole clutch drum with a heat gun and the bearings will just fall off. I don't know if you heard this noise, but look at the bearing. It already slide it out, so it's that easy. Now for the other bearing. Now clean this up pretty good. For the ball bearing kit, Vitorazzi will send you two different bearings. One will have rubber caps and one will have metal caps. Please be sure that you install the ball bearing with the rubber caps inside the clutch drum, where the clutch sits, because this ball bearing is sealed against the dust that the clutch is producing while sleeping. And install the one with the metal caps on the outside. Here is clean and we actually have a cap that protects against dust and debris. Installing the ball bearings is just as simple as removing them using heat, a little bit of grease, and they will just slide in. Don't apply too much grease though, because during functioning, this clutch drum can get really hot, the grease will melt and will just go all the way around the clutch, making the clutch slip. Now we will apply the same method with the heat gun for installing them. One is in. Second is in. And it's just that simple. Now install the safety C-clip back. Please be sure that it locks in place, like this. And the installation of the ball bearings in the clutch drum is now complete. Now, all that we need to do is to install it back on the engine. You may ask me why I didn't use a thermometer, infrared or laser one. To be honest, I've done it so many times that I kind of know how a part heated up to 130, 150 degrees should feel like. And you should be able to touch it for 1 second, no more, and after 1 second it would be unbearable. Installing the clutch drum back onto the crankshaft will be done using heat. What Vitorazzi recommends is heating up the ball bearings from the outer side, from the side with the bearing that has metallic caps, and they recommend of doing 4 cycles of 2 seconds of the heat gun, 2 seconds off, 2 seconds of the heat gun, 2 seconds off. From my personal experience and what I found out that works a little bit better is just doing 4 cycles of 4 seconds of the heat gun, 2 seconds off. 4 seconds of the heat gun, 2 seconds off. You will heat up the bearings a little bit better and they will slide way better onto the crankshaft. And doing that, you don't risk to heat up the bearings so much that you will damage them in any way. After applying a very small amount of grease onto the crankshaft for allowing the bearings to slide better, now let's start the heat cycles. Let the heat gun be pretty hot and we will do 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Should be ready to install. And it's just as simple as that. Now install the safety C-clip back. Be sure that it snaps in place. Now we will install the new protection cap. All that we need to do now is to install the big pulley, the belt, retension the belt, and we are done. For the correct installation and retensioning of the belt, please be sure that you check the video where we showed you how to replace and retension the belt. I will add the link to that video in the description down below. After we mount everything back to the engine, we tension the belt to the correct specifications, we now successfully changed the bearings onto the clutch drum. Now you should be good for at least 100 hours of flying without any kind of worries about that. Thank you very much for watching. Please hit the like and subscribe button because we have a lot more videos to come where we will do a complete service to this engine and record every single operation for you guys to show you how you should do it home. So please go to the eshop.scottparamotor.com and buy every single spare part that you need because you can find them there very easy and accessible with the next day delivery. See you in the next one. Ciao.